This is Inspiration, proudly sponsored by C&D 24-Hour Nursing, committed and dedicated to care. Today on an extra special edition of Inspiration.
It's time for Anastasia's Recipe of the Day.
Welcome back to Anastasia's Recipe of the Day. If you've just tuned in, hi, wa anasutashi. And that means, hi, I'm Anastasia in Chinese. This recipe is fluffy jasmine rice, big plump juicy shrimp, crunchy peas and carrots, and crispy bacon tossed with fragrant scallions tied together with a slightly sweet garlic sesame sauce.
It's gonna be good.
Anastasia's recipe of the day, Chinese shrimp fried rice with bacon.
Anastasia's Recipe of the Day.
Yes, ma'am, you are so right. It is time for Anastasia's Recipe of the Day. Welcome. I'm Anastasia, and on Anastasia's Recipe of the Day, we make up the most tasty recipes that your taste buds will ever lay their smackers on. And today I've got a really nice one, Chinese shrimp fried rice with bacon. This one was requested by Royan on Facebook. Hi, Royan. Thanks for requesting this one. I hope you're going to try it and let me know how it comes out. This recipe is fluffy jasmine rice, big plump juicy shrimp, crunchy peas and carrots, and crispy bacon tossed with fragrant scallions tied together with a slightly sweet garlic sesame sauce. It's gonna be good. Here are the ingredients for the Chinese shrimp fried rice with bacon, and guess what? You can use any kind of meat that you like. You can use chicken or beef or pork or a combination. You don't have to use shrimp and you don't have to use bacon. But I'm going to use them in my recipe today because it's just a phenomenal combination. You need 1/4 cup of garlic sesame sauce, and I have the recipe attached to my Facebook notes, so please be sure to go ahead and check that out. 2 cups of jasmine rice cooked one day in advance. 3 ounces of bay shrimp peeled and deveined. 4 ounces of bacon cut into 1/2-inch pieces. 1 egg scrambled. 2 ounces of peas and carrots frozen. You want 2 tablespoons of green onions chopped up really nicely, and 2 tablespoons of vegetable oil, or you can use peanut oil. Whichever one you prefer, it's completely up to you. Those are the ingredients that are going to cook up a wonderful Chinese shrimp fried rice with bacon. And listen, we're going to take a song break, and then I'm going to come back and tell you how to put it all together. We're going all the way down to Louisiana. We're going to check in with Mr. Aaron Neville. He says, let it snow. So when he comes back, we're going to... Stop it, Anastasia. I'm going to tell you exactly how to put this all together. So please stick around. This is Anastasia's Recipe of the Day on Inspiration.
It's the most wonderful time of the year.
Inspiration.
The weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. It doesn't show signs of stopping, and I brought some corn for popping. The lights are turning way down low. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. When we finally kiss goodnight, how I'll hate going out in the storm. But if you really, really hold me tight, all the way home I'll be warm. The fire is slowly dying, and my dear, we're still goodbying. But as long as you love me so, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. good night. How I'll hate going out in the storm. But if you really, really hold me tight, all the way home I'll be warm. The fire is slowly dying, and my dear, we're still goodbying. But as long as you love me so, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Oh, 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 let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
Welcome back to Anastasia's Recipe of the Day. If you've just tuned in, hi, wa anasutashi. That means, hi, I'm Anastasia in Chinese. This recipe is so inspirational. We're making Chinese shrimp fried rice with bacon. It makes you think that you can speak Chinese when truly, in fact, you can't. But you know what? Everybody always used to tell me I look like a Chinese, and I think I still do. I have some Chinese roots somewhere up in me. Note to self-talk with mom and dad after recipe. Now, let's get back to the directions. How do we put this Chinese rice together? First of all, there are two things that you really need to always remember when you're making Chinese rice. There are two commandments. Number one, always use day-old rice. Because if you use freshly steamed rice, the steam really doesn't make it an appropriate kind of rice to use to fry, because it can kind of make the fried rice really gummy. So use day-old refrigerated rice. Secondly, always cook at a very high heat. It not only allows you to incorporate the flavors really nicely, cooking at a high heat allows the water in the rice to evaporate it. Did I say to evaporate it? To evaporate, I'm sorry. But here's how to put this Chinese rice together. And of course, this one was requested by Royanne. You want to, first of all, slice your bacon into half-inch pieces and set that aside. Bang! Then you're going to rinse and drain your frozen peas and carrots and your bay shrimp. You want to chop your green onions and set those aside. Then you're going to break your egg into a bowl and beat it up really nicely as though you're going to scramble it, because you are. Then you're going to heat a saute pan at medium heat. You're going to add about 1 tablespoon of oil. And when it's hot, you're going to slowly pour in and let the egg bubble up a little bit. Then stir it until it's done. And remove the egg and cut it up into small pieces and set that aside. If you've ever wondered how all that nice egg gets all mixed up in your Chinese rice, that's how. You're going to heat your wok or your pan about 30 seconds at medium heat. Add your sliced bacon, and you're going to stir them to separate, and then you're going to cook it until it's nice and crispy, about 3 to 5 minutes. Once they are nice and crisp, you're going to blot off the excess oil using a clean paper towel, and you're going to heat your wok at medium-high heat. Add about 2 tablespoons of oil, and then you're going to add the cooked rice and stir-fry it until it's piping hot. About 4 to 6 minutes will do you. You're going to add your peas and your carrots and your shrimp and stir fry them together for 1 minute. Then you're going to add your garlic sesame glaze sauce, the eggs and the bacon, and you're going to toss it really well, and you finish it with a nice sprinkling of chopped green scallions. Mix it really well. Oh my goodness, I have made myself want some Chinese food. Do you understand me? Listen, I hope you're going to try this recipe. Let me know how it comes out. And please stay tuned right here to my Facebook page and YouTube for more Anastasia's Recipe of the Day. I just love doing the scrum deliciousness with you. Two short things before I go. How xun xun xiong shou. In English, that means
good luck and enjoy.